song for the broken hearted.
From the Bangor Auditorium, welcome to TV5 sports coverage of the Maine Principals Association Class A Boys High School Basketball Tournament. Next, it's the Boys Class A State Final as the Rams of Deering take on the Rams of Bangor.
Well, hello everyone. Welcome back to the Bangor Auditorium for game number two of our championship doubleheader. The two number one seeds coming in. I'm Mike Hale, along with my broadcast partner tonight, Bob Simbalek. And number one from Western Maine, of course, Deering. A lot of people have been talking about this team. They're undefeated at 21-0. Bangor at 20-1, the Eastern Maine number one seed. Only loss on the year came to Nokomis. And they'll square off tonight here at the Bangor Auditorium. And Bob Simbalek, two contrasting styles here. Bangor likes to keep a team down around 50, play a lot of defense, and Deering has not been held under 60 points all year. Get a couple of star players who can light it up. So two different teams facing off for the championship tonight.
Well, the key to the ball game tonight for Bangor will be if they can control tempo, get in the half court, slow things down. I'm sure Coach Reed would like to score in the mid-40s. If it gets above 60, I think you can find Bangor's in trouble. Deering has got a lot of great athletes, but Bangor has Joe Campbell, and Bangor has one other thing going for them. Well, they have two things going for them, in my opinion. One, they have the Bangor Auditorium, which is not an easy place to play. Deering hasn't played here. And secondly, they have tradition. They've won four state championships in the 90s, so they know what it's like to be here. The pressure is on Deering, not on Bangor.
Well, there's two players that have been talked about a lot. Jamal Katarina and Nick Canner-Medley. Two players are being recruited by a lot of colleges. They are Division I type ball players, and Bangor will be looking at them tonight.
Right, but Bangor counters with Joe Campbell, who certainly is one of the finalists for the, you know, the Mr. Basketball Award, along with Katarina.
All right, thank you, Bob. Let's go to Tim Throckmorton with the coaches. Tim?
Mike Francoeur is here with us for Deering, and of course, you know, you come up here, you're the visitor, but with your lineup, you've been the hunted all year long, haven't you?
Well, certainly, teams have certainly been shooting to come get us, but we feel the underdog tonight here at Bangor. They're the defending state champs. We're just hoping to play well.
Is your team, you had a chance to come up and watch Bangor last week. What did you notice that they did exceptionally well?
Well, they're certainly very well coached. The Campbell kid's an awful nice player. Van Enestein, they've got a lot of kids that just know how to win, and hopefully we can take some of those things away tonight.
You have some great individual athletes. Have they played well as a team this whole season?
Well, you know, I think that's been the big difference for us. We've been able to, as a unit, come together. When one kid's not on all cylinders, other players step up and make the plays. I'm very lucky to be where I am. I've got some real nice kids, and I'm looking forward to tonight.
You've been a head coach for quite a while. You walked into a situation where it's almost assumed you'd get a chance to play in this this game. Is there any pressure left anymore, or you just let them go and let them see what happens?
Well, I'm hoping to sit out tonight. I think that they're talented enough that it isn't me. I'm very lucky to be where I am, like I said earlier, and it's been 10 years I've been in this. First time I've been to the auditorium. It's certainly quite an environment.
Best of luck to the Deering Rams tonight.
Thank you very much.
Deering, of course, against Bangor, the other Rams, coached by Roger Reed, who, for St. Paddy's Day, has dressed appropriately here with the green tie and the green coat. You'd like to have it a good night for the red as well.
Yes. This is going to be a very tough game tonight, Tim.
You've got a couple of prospects that are being recruited by a lot of Division I coaches. Can individual players come out and sort of even take over a game of this magnitude in a state championship game? Does it still work that way?
Oh, yeah. We know that they've got three outstanding players and a nice cast that work around them. We really don't match up with them very well when you look at paper, but you got to come out here and do it on the floor. And we're going to try to limit their opportunities tonight. We're going to try to defend them the best way we can according to their strengths, what they like to do. And hopefully we are able to keep this game at a tempo that's that we like to play at and not one they like to play at.
Joe Campbell didn't have a lot of opportunity to score against Skowhegan. Will you try to get him somehow some more touches, or do you expect Deering to come down and try to let other players beat you?
Well, I think Deering's going to try a variety of zone stuff tonight. And unlike Skowhegan, who had a combination defense on him, they played him man and zone. I don't know what they will do, but if they do what Skowhegan did with a diamond in one, that really makes it very difficult because they're very big start with, and if they do that inside of a zone, we're going to have other guys hit shots.
The way people have been talking, Roger, the last week, you wouldn't know that you were the defending state champion. Best of luck tonight, okay, Roger?
That's true. They're supposed to have had this wrapped up in November, so we'll just take a good shot at it tonight, Tim.
We'll see what the Northern Rams can do. Congratulations. Right. Best of luck tonight, Roger Reed. And, of course, it's the Battle of the Rams. Bangor against Deering. One more gold ball to be handed out tonight. And a bunch of players to meet in just a couple of moments.
Tournament is brought to you by the University of Maine. Get the Black Bear Experience. By Hammond Lumber Company, with locations in Auburn, Belgrade, Fairfield, Farmington, Greenville, and Skowhegan. By Quirk Auto Park, Hogan Road, Bangor, where buying or leasing a vehicle is a walk in the park. By Bangor International Airport, bringing the world within reach of Maine. Full details at flybangor.com. By the Maine Education Association. Our 25,000 members are proud to say that Maine's public schools are number one in the nation for student achievement. By Northern Mattress Furniture Galleries, with four showrooms in Bangor, Brunswick, Fairfield, and South Portland. By Hassan College, Maine's College of Business, Health, Education, and Professional Studies. And by Agway Home and Garden Showplace, Farmingdale, Winslow, and Skowhegan, making beautiful gardens come alive.
All right, welcome back to the Bangor Auditorium. Mike Hale and Bob Cymbalek with you for the Bangor Deering State Championship game. And Deering in their first state final in 64 years. Goes back to 1937. You remember that, Bob?
That was the year I was born, 1937. I don't think I remember it.
Winslow won it 16-14, so it's been a long dry spell. Bangor's had some good recent years with Roger Reed and the crew since the early 90s through now.
Well, they've been the dominant team, Michael. They've won four state championships in the 90s. So Roger has done an outstanding job at Bangor. And Bangor has great tradition. I only tell you, the only thing I know for sure tonight, the Rams will win.
Yeah, you can go for that. The Bangor Rams and the Deering Rams squaring off here. Bangor beating Waterville, Nokomis, and Skowhegan to get here. Deering beating Windham, Massabesic, and Westbrook. Skowhegan did everything they had to do. They shut down Joe Campbell. It was a low-scoring game, and Bangor, at times, not playing particularly well and still came out with a one-point win.
They outshot Bangor from the floor. They outshot him from the foul line. They out-rebounded him, and they also out-turnovered him. They had 18 turnovers to Bangor 7, and that was the difference in the ball game. Had they not turned the ball over, Skowhegan probably would have been here tonight. However, they did turn it over. Credit Bangor's defense for that. And I look for tonight, again, the key thing is tempo. You know, I'm sure that Deering has not faced a team that's played as good man-to-man as Bangor does during the course of the season. Bangor's an outstanding defensive team, and I look for them to work real hard in the half court, slow things down, control the tempo, and try to keep the score in the 40s. When it gets to 50 and above, Bangor's chances of winning are going to decrease as the score gets higher, Mike.
Bangor defending state champs beat Westbrook last year in Portland by a score of 45-36. Deering with an unblemished record at 21-0. Bangor with one loss on the season when they lost midway through the year down in Newport against Nokomis. They're able to revenge that a couple of times, regular season and in the tournament. All right, we're going to take a break. We'll come back and meet the players here shortly between Bangor and Deering. We'll be back in 60 seconds.